Hi, welcome to automationtesting.in. In this video, we are going to see capture screenshot for failed tests. Now, capture screenshot for failed test in testng will discuss about how to take a screenshot when there is a failure in your test case execution. The screenshot will give the information about on which screen the script got failed during the execution. Then we can easily identify the issue by looking into the screenshot. To achieve this, we need to write two utility classes. One is to take the screenshot and another is to listen to the test status result and take the screenshot accordingly. For this, we need to use listeners in testng. We need to implement the ITestListener interface from the testng in order to get the status of the test cases. If the test cases fail, then it will track the information and then will take the screenshot using the screenshot utility. Means testng will not take any screenshot. We have to write separate logic to take the screenshot, but you have to use this utility or this take screenshot method in the listeners to take the screenshot when there is a failure. Means we have to mention that how it should capture. Okay, now the example, you know, we will discuss in this video is we will take four classes, means Java files, and one is testng.xml file. The reason behind taking this one is if you take standalone while writing the framework, you will get confused, means how to capture this kind of scenarios. So to make it easy in the framework level, I am using this way. Means I'll take one main test. In this, I will simply initialize the web driver. Okay, then I'll use that web driver wherever I want, and I'll extend this class to get that web driver. Why? Because while writing your test suite, you will write so many test cases and so many test classes, and each and every test class you will use driver object, and the driver object should be single for your entire test suite. Means once you initialize, you have to use the same web driver reference for all the test cases, then only your test suite will execute. Otherwise, you will get issues. To achieve that, I'm using this way. Means main test will be used to initialize the web driver, and we'll use the utility that captures the screenshot, and we'll use the listener class to implement the ITestListener. And this is our actual test cases where our requirement is. Then we'll execute this test case using this testng.xml file. Okay, now we'll jump into the Eclipse and we'll see this practically. I'm in Eclipse and I have created one package called com.automationtesting.screenshot. Now we'll create all the tests in this package. I'll create a class called main test. Okay, main test. In this, I will not do anything. I'll create one web driver reference. Static web driver. That's it in this. Okay, that's what I want to write in this main test, only single line. Okay, now I'll create one more class for screenshot utility. Okay, yeah, this is the get screenshot class, and I have not written this one. I took it from another class already written. I don't want to waste the time. The reason behind is our intention is to get the failed test, how it will cap. Now we'll discuss what is get screenshot. We have one of the interfaces called in Selenium is take screenshot. So we cannot create an object to interface, so we are wrapping to the driver object. So take screenshot reference equal to take screenshot of driver. Okay, then we are using one more class called file. File source equal to ts dot, we have one of the methods called get screenshot as. How you want to take the screenshot? As a file, output type equal to file. You have to take this as a file. And then where you want to store this file? String dist equal to system.setProperty user.dir. Till here, it will give you your current project folder. Okay, in that I have a folder called error screenshot. In that error screenshot, I am placing this as screenshot name.png. I'll pass the screenshot name, my own screenshot name, and that.png. Okay, and the destination means file destination equal to new file. We have to create the new file of this destination. Means we have now source. Source is we have taken the screenshot. Now we have destination. We have to copy the file from the source to destination. Means file utils is one of the class having method called copy file. File utils dot copy file source and destination. Means from here to here you have to copy. And this method will give you the path of your source, means our destination where you have captured a screenshot, means this error screenshot, screenshot name, that it will give you back. It will return that screenshot. Okay, this is what in the get screenshot. Now, I'll take one more class for the listener. Okay. One more in the same package. I'll name it as listener test. Okay, listener test, and it this class will listen the status of your test case execution, means whether it is passed, failed, if passed what should happen, if fail what should happen kind of information. For this we need to implement ITestListener. Implements ITestListener. Okay, import this one from r.testng. Now why it is showing an error? Add unimplemented methods. You have given one of the intelligence that add unimplemented methods. When you implement any interface, you have to implement all the methods which are available in that interface into your class. So I'll click on this. Now it will show all the methods which are available in the ITestListener. You see onTest dot, onTest success, onTest failure, onTest skipped, and onStart, onFinish. These are the methods available in the ITestListener interface, and those will not have any implementation. So we need to implement all these things without fail. Now, and writing implementation for all the methods is mandatory? No. This is not mandatory, implement all the methods, but you have to mention that in your class, whether you write logic for this method or not, but you have to write this. If you remove this one, it will throw an error. See? And that is the reason you have to implement all the methods. Whether you write logic for this or not, you leave blank if you don't want, but you have to mention that in your class. Now, you have so many methods, but what is our interest? On test failure. Why? Because if there is a failure, we have to take the screenshot. So we are interested in on test failure. So we'll implement this one. Now what I'll do, we have a method called get screenshot, means capture. We have one of the utility class. I'll use this utility class, get screenshot dot capture. Okay, get screenshot dot capture. I want to give the name to the screenshot name. What name I want to give, that is your own, how you want to handle this one. Here I am taking method name. Okay, in which method it failed, I am giving the method name. How you will get that method name? You have ITest result object, right? This result dot get name means this method will give you the result.getName will give you the method name of failure test method. Okay, it is throwing like surrounded by try catch. Okay, this is what I want to implement in this onTest failure. Once there is a failure, you take the screenshot with that method name. Okay, and it will place where it will come here. Screenshot name will be given here, and the screenshot name will be given in the error screenshot. Okay, now we have given main test, get screenshot, listener test. Now what is pending? Now our pending is actual test case which we want to execute. Okay, now I'll take one sample class to implement our test cases. I have written one test called capture screenshot tests. Okay, this is our actual test case. We will write this test case and we will execute this one. Once there is a failure in this test case, then we'll have to capture the screenshot. Now, I have written a class called capture screenshots. In that, I have one method called capture screenshot. Okay? And I am extending main test. Why I am extending main test? The reason behind is I want to capture the driver object. Okay, why I will do capture this is from main test means if you have more than one test case in another class also, I have to use the same driver object. Then my test case will execute using one browser. Otherwise, it should throw an exception. The reason behind that, we took main test and I'm extending, then I'll access this driver. Means if you click on this, it will go to pointer to this driver. That is the reason we will use this. Now, I'm using Selenium 3. So you have to mention gecko-driver.exe to launch the Firefox driver. System.setProperty, webdriver.firefox.marionette, and you have to mention where the gecko-driver.exe is. And then I'm launching driver equal new Firefox driver and driver.get. I am navigating to automationtesting.in. This is my official website. There you can find all these blocks. Okay? And once I navigate, I am taking string title equal driver.getTitle and I am asserting the title. Okay? I am asserting the title means this title home automation test. Actually, the title is automation testing. But I have given automation test intentionally. Why? Because I want to fail here. Then we'll take the screenshot of that screen. So I am failing here. And driver.close. This is my test case. Now I want to run this test case using testng.xml file. If you go here, I have already written testng.xml file. You have to use this listeners. This is your class. Class name equal to your class name with your package name. That is common. What you have to use an extra is listeners tags. Listeners, in the listeners you have to write listener class name equal to what is the listener name? Listener test. In the listener test, that is in this package. You have to give the package name also. com.automationtesting.screenshot.listenerTest. Now if you execute this test case, this listener will listen your test status and then act accordingly. Okay, now we have to implement this listeners in this and you right click then run as testng suit. Now it will execute the test case which we have written. Sorry, we have a failure. I'll just look into that. The test is capture screenshot is not available. Sorry, this name is capture screenshot tests. Okay, I'll rename it capture screenshot tests. I have given wrong name, that is the reason it is saying cannot find the class. Okay, now we have corrected this one. Now I'll right click run as testng suit. Now it is executing. We will see what will happen. It should launch the browser and it should navigate to automationtesting.in and it should capture the driver title of the web page and it should assert whether the title is correct or not. Yeah, it launched the browser. Now it is navigating to automationtesting.in. And that's all. Okay, now if you observe here, I hover here, see home automation testing. Actually the title is home hyphen automation testing and we have written that driver.close, but the Firefox did not close it. The reason is the test got failed in this step. Once it is fails, it will not execute next lines. That is the reason it did not close. Means there is a failure. Okay, once there is a failure, the listener test will listen to this test. So on test failure, what it should happen? It should take the screenshot of that screen. Means the screenshot of automation testing.in. And I am giving the result.getName as a screenshot name. What is the method name? The method name is CaptureScreenshot. It will take this CaptureScreenshot and it will place here with that name in the error screenshot folder. Now I have a folder called error screenshot here. Nothing in this. I'll refresh this one. Refresh this one. See, you can see CaptureScreenshot.png. Now I'll open this. I'll go to properties. I'll take the path and I'll paste here, like if you click this one, now we can find screenshot of that failure. Means you see the entire screen it took as a screenshot. Why? Because in this screen it got failed. Means the screen of this title is wrong. We did not assert it correctly. So it took this screenshot and placed it in the folder, in this folder. This way you can capture the screenshot of fail test when there is a failure. For this, we have to write your actual test here, and I am using one utility, extends main test, and this is common code. And we have to write one listener. We have to write one listener, and this listener on test failure, you have to capture the screenshot. And the main test, I am writing only initializing web driver. The reason is, if you have working in the framework level also, it should work. And I am executing this from the testng.xml file. And you have to mention the listener, which listener you are using in the script. Okay, that's all in this video. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to Automation Testing channel. And please like us at our Facebook page.